And then as the power play rolled around, that's when Bernier got really good. 32 for 32 for Jonathan Bernier. It doesn't seem like there's 32 shots on goal, but he's been excellent. Really economical in goal, except for that.
Unbelievable. Oliver Ekman-Larsson can't believe it. And the game is tied on a shorthanded goal at the five-second mark of this third period.
The opening faceoff will go to Oliver Ekman-Larsson. He's just going to shovel this down the ice. Look, he's at his own blue line. That's 140 feet. It bounces and goes right past Bernier on the glove side. Wow.
Let's see why Semin didn't come on the ice and why the Hurricanes had just three players. Oh, you see some intent there from the Anaheim player. I thought it was inadvertent. No, it wasn't. And the stick came out of his hands. So, you know, he was completely paralyzed by the whole situation.
So Perry's involved with most whistles and most scrubs. This is from game one. He's getting a drink of water. There's his Olympic teammate, Jeff Carter. Watch what he does with the water bottle here. As Carter's putting the tape back, Perry fills his glove up with water. And Carter doesn't realize until he gets his hand in there and he just tells the linesman basically what a clown this guy is. That's good stuff.
That is good stuff.
Pezzik gaining the line. He takes a shot. Rebound! He shoots it up in the air. It's right to go, Greece. Where's the puck? Is it in the net? The Sabres think it's in the net. The goaltender's in the net. And Mike Smith is cheating like crazy. He's trying to move his knees to move it out of there.
You know where this puck is? The back of his pants. Watch this. The puck's going to drop right here. Hansel tries for it. It falls right in the back of his pants.
Lord.
And watch this.
Oh,
it's landing in his pants, and he's going to take it right there, right into the net. You can see the puck laying on the top of his pants on his jersey in the net. You see it right there. You can see the puck right there. See it?
Yeah, I see it, but I've never seen anything like this before.
It's Christmas.
Well, it's Christmas for one team. It's bah humbug for the other one.
After review of the play, the puck did cross the line. We have a good goal.
And the Buffalo Sabres win it in overtime.
Out of the net, Ward to play it away from Kadri. This could be an ice.
He just plain misplayed it. And as long as it's not touched, that's icing, and then it comes off the boards, and you can see the reaction by Jonathan Bernier on the play. Takes his eyes off the puck for a moment, and it goes off the inside of his skates into the net. He just plain fans on it.
Puck is played in by Hudler. Bishop to play it.
Fired it up, they score! It's fired right in by Camilleri on the steal. Bishop trying to get it out of the wing. He put it right on Camilleri's stick, and he rifled it home for the game-opening goal.
Well, sometimes your best play is no play, and if you don't think you have something, just leave it behind the net for your defenseman.
Up the wall. That's all you do. You got all the guys in your zone up the wall.
And Bishop out to play it, and he will play it up the wall this time. It bounced to the point. Byard deflected. They score! Westgarth jammed it in on the rebound, and Calgary has scored twice in the span of 15 seconds. Sellout crowd, 19,092, 67th consecutive sellout, and they score! It's driven in from center ice, and it bounced off the glass support and threw Bishop into the net. Danny DeKeyser drove it in from center. Bishop shaking his head at that one. It's now 5-4 with 2:05 to go.
To say stunning would be understatement. This comes off on an incredible angle, a big-time slap shot that hits the stanchion that holds the glass in between. I mean, you never see an angle like that.
I'm just trying to keep the Rangers in check.
That puck got through Bernier! Derek Stepan gets the goal! But there's a gift goal for the Rangers.
Just the way Bernier's year has gone so far.
Broussard lifts that head for Hagelin, streaking in the backhand. John Brass pulls, he scores! Last stumble, and the puck trickles in.
The Rangers needed a break, and they get one here. A nice little pass into Hagelin. Lose it going forward, and Cooper Rask just catches an edge and then can't get it with his stick. He had time to recover as well.
He didn't play one that went through Terabyte and back down. Coming out is Bishop, poked away.
Well, a clear by Teravainen. Bishop comes out to play it. He misses it, runs right into Victor Hedman, and a slam dunk for Patrick Sharp.
And that's a big body collision between two huge men. Patrick Sharp with the gimme goal. Look at that impact between Hedman and Bishop.
Riley Sheahan, good play by him. Anderson shoots. Bishop makes the save. Rebound. They score. It's the magic puck. And it's 2-0 Detroit.
Sometimes you just try and do too much. And Ben Bishop makes a good save on the first shot. And then he tries to clear it like a tennis racket. Rolling puck shot. And he tries to clear it. He clears it in his own net. You're trying to just clear it behind the net. And instead, it's off the post and in. Right after it went in, you can see him disgustedly talking to himself.
So, Brick, a very important penalty kill here. We begin the second period.
Right pass, Rodney Pyle goes right to goal with it. The turn left shot, scores! Daniel Pyle, shorthanded goal, his first in 22 games.
Wheeler going toward the corner of Ward, bumps it to space. Krejci steals the puck to Wheeler. He scores! Two shorthanded goals on the same shift. The Bruins score twice, and they're ahead by two. Astounding stuff. Here's a long pass for Bejel with Paille middle, a shot. Score!
Make it three! They have equaled their shorthanded output for the season in a single penalty kill.
I don't know if I've ever seen anything like this. Three shorthanded goals on the same power play. This is a milestone moment.
Receiving end from Getzlaff. Bounces in front. Bobby Ryan gets a stick on it, has it slashed away. Looks around, palms skyward as if to say, why is that not a penalty? That was strange. Ludman with a shot. Rebound! Bobby Ryan scores! And give an assist to Miettinen because the stick was right there for Ryan to pick up.
I've never seen that in my life.
That was something.
I have to be honest. Watch Bobby Ryan right here. Stop her right here. And there's Koivu, and he's going to grab Bobby Ryan's stick. So roll it forward. So he now has Bobby Ryan's stick. So that was Koivu's stick that was on the ice. So he actually scored that goal with Mikko Koivu's stick, and that's why he was showing the shaft of the stick at the end. That is,
and we've
just
gotten to the bottom of it.
That's hysterical. Absolutely hysterical.
Surprise attack, first line against fourth for Philadelphia. Grossman shoots intentionally wide, they score!
A bounce off the end boards and tucked into the side of the net. 4-3 Philadelphia, Raffo will get the goal.
You see in so many buildings, the bounce off the backboards. This one is really unusual, but look at how far into the corner this goes. I mean, it's past that line and Bernier just didn't pick it up.
Open ice, but still man on man.
Kings won the draw on a drive. It picked up in front, and Smith scores! He took it off the boards and he tucked it in.
It's going to be in, Bob. They're keeping the play going. It appeared to me the puck was all the way over the line. Of course, they do use video replay, but it's taken away by San Jose. A turn shot, and it looked like it went in, but no. Held out, it was Setoguchi. That looked like it got behind Bernier.
If that one goes in, and Smith's goes in. Smith counts, nothing happens for the Sharks.
They've gone a long time without a whistle. Cutting in now, Mitchell, score!
But it may not count. It may not count. If Smith's goal was good, none of this will count.
The Doughty shot, the bounce off the boards, watch Smith. Gets with a stick, kick, and it is, it's over the line. So LA's goal counts, San Jose's goal does not.
Back across the Sharks. Here is Taves for Kane, saved by Anderson, and then it's knocked in! The Blackhawks win in overtime, Andrew Shaw!
Oh my goodness!
Wow!
That is incredible. He headbutts it in. What a soccer play.
Shaw with the header to beat Anderson. Have you ever seen that, Joe?
No.
The Chicago person deliberately headbutted the puck in the net, no goal.
That is a first for me.
I've never seen it, ever. Trying to get it around Lucas Pisa. And a penalty coming up against Pisa as he trips up Holmberg. Holmberg back and forth, down low, out of the corner to Weidman, and he drifts one all the way down.
Oh, look at this!
This is going in the net!
The Calgary Flames put one in their own net! And it's 1-0 Vancouver. Oh, boy.
That's Weidman tries to go D-to-D, catches Raymond in a bad spot, and my goodness. If you're Calgary, you're thinking, are you kidding me? Could this possibly happen to us?
gets lapped with Perry streaking to the front of the net. Perry turns right out in front. It comes. Nobody there. It's headed to the empty net. Will it make it? Yes, it does. Corey Perry scores on his own goal from behind the Oilers net. And the Edmonton Oilers will see a six-game losing streak snapped.
Must have been the side of the net. Looked like it went off the stick of Dubnyk, which I thought it did, but it might have gone off the side of the net. I don't think anyone for Edmonton really cares right now. It's a win, and they've been looking for that for a while.
Koivu wins the draw. Ellis hustles to the bench as Perry brings it into the Nashville zone. Throws a bouncing puck. It's in! A bouncing puck. I think, again, another own goal off a Nashville defender.
Ryan Suter kicks it into the top of the net.
It went off the crossbar and in. That's the second goal that's gone in off of Suter.
Corey Perry just lofted. Watch Suter. Hacky sack. Oh. Right off the crossbar and into the net.
And the penalty expires. Nielsen intercepts and sends it back down to Toronto zone. Now Grabber with a steal on Bernie. Grabber on score! With a steal on Bernier, and the Islanders lead 2-1.
Bernier tries to go paddle down to keep this one over the goal line. Gets in behind there, can't play it, and then a little slow getting back into his creases. Grabner with a quick wraparound beats him to the post. That is just poorly done by Jonathan Bernier.
Best power play in the league, by the way, belongs to the Pittsburgh Penguins. But here's Grabner, and he scores! Short-handed goal! And the Islanders tie it 1-1 as Grabner rediscovers his Olympic form. Andrew McDonald clears out. 7 seconds remain to Bolton's penalty. And a giveaway, they score! Grabner again! Miscommunication between the defenseman Riley and the goaltender Bernier. It's Grabner 2, Toronto 1. It will be his second shorthanded goal on the same penalty kill.
We remember back last time that Grabner and Bernier got involved. Remember the bad play behind the net? And that's just a terrible play by Bernier. I mean, I don't know what he's thinking. He's coming out. You got to make your decision quicker than that.
And Hamilton has to scramble back quickly. Under duress. Stone, an empty net. Mark Stone across. Kyle Turris scores! And the Ottawa Senators get the regulation win they were looking for.
There's burgers everywhere. It's raining burgers out here. People are being selfish and just throwing the bun. Where's the meat? I think Curtis Lazar's having a little post-game snack right now. Hope there's not a weigh-in tomorrow morning.
I don't think the Flyers could have played a better first period, Joe, the way they came out against this Capitals team. But
oh, no! A dump-in from beyond center squirts through. Washington leads by 2.
They were on a line change, Joe. They were ready to get on the bench, and now they're congratulating Chimera, and they are smiling like you wouldn't believe. A goal that you're not going to ever see probably again. And there's the goaltender Mason playing it completely wrong. No stick. The stick does not cover up the 5-hole. And the Capitals have a 2-0 lead on this goal from center ice.
And one final question. The gentleman that was sitting behind the bench, any comments on that?
I did not see him. No, the only time I wondered is Lonnie Cameron came up and said, told me, Mac, you got to turn around and see your relatives in town. And I was like, well, Lonnie, I can't turn around and look. I'm standing on the bench. Apparently, there's quite a resemblance. I hope he gets as much help as I get around town.
Now he lets it go. Good block by Huskins. Back to the line, Edler. And that puck.
The referees have called this a good goal.
Everybody is
looking for it. Everybody stops. Now when we see it come into the frame and it's in the net.
And then all of a sudden it disappeared. It appeared in the net. I still have no idea what happened there. Here's Edler on the right side of your screen.
There's where it goes up the glass. Hits the stanchion.
Oh, it hits the stanchion. And Bieksa shoots it.
Nobody could see it. That was the first angle that showed us what really happened. Players on both sides were looking around, but Kevin Bieksa is going to be the overtime hero here. What a bizarre ending.
28th penalty kill. But up, we'll get a chance to ice it. And didn't get it out, and does get it out.
That's got to go down.
Here are the Blues with Oshie. To Backes. Backes shooting! Where's the puck? They score!
That's why it has to go down.
I think Phaneuf was worried about hitting his own man, and he hesitated. And when you hesitate, you're lost.
And then Bernier gets caught retreating a little bit here as the puck goes right between his legs and in the net.
A direct reaction to what Lovejoy did. You see Patrick Waugh's reaction to that as well. Well, we knew we were going to get fire and passion from Patrick Waugh. We're seeing that right at the end of game number one as he makes his debut as a head coach in the National Hockey League. I think we got a little rivalry. We look forward to this season in Peter Game between the Avalanche and the Ducks. I don't think we've seen the last of this.
Let's see if he can do it. Doan comes in.
Scores!
On a broken stick!
That is as greasy as a goal as you're ever gonna see. And it couldn't happen to a better guy. Shane Doan just rips it. And maybe it was the broken blade that almost took off the head of Anderson. Anderson stops the blade, but does not stop the puck. He takes it blade in the right shoulder.
That's exactly what it is. Ryan Getzlaff, 0 for 1, here he comes. Stopped by Dubnyk, and the Coyotes have defeated the number one team of the National Hockey League in the shootout.
Shane Doan, do you have a name for that shot?
No, I don't have anything for that.
What exactly happened on that?
I think that's the old exploding sticks trick. So I don't know what happened, but obviously we'll take a win.